Hello, is that Dr. Pi?
Yeah, speaking.
Can you get us some transcripts from YouTube?
Transcripts? Yeah, okay, I'll do that.
We will be awfully grateful if you can do this.
Lovely job. All right, thank you. Hello everybody, in this video we're going to look at how to get the transcript of a YouTube video automatically. So we're going to be using Python code to do this. So let's look at how we're going to go about it. So firstly, we want to get the ID of the YouTube video. So the ID is the last part of the URL of the video that you're watching that you want to get the transcript from. Next, we want to add the ID to our Python code. And once we've done that, we can then pass the output and we can save it to a text file, or we can do some NLP with it if we want. So we've all got our own reasons for passing it and for actually extracting the transcript anyway. Obviously there's manual ways of doing this and there are browser extensions, but we want to do this programmatically. And also we may want to do it for many, many videos, so you don't want to sit there, keep clicking, right clicking, copy and pasting and so on. So as I said, the part of the URL which represents the ID which you will need to get is this. So after the equals, and there's a little gotcha actually, which I'll show you in the code in a minute, where if it begins with a backslash. So that's what you need to do. And once you've got the video ID, then it's time to install pip install youtube-transcript-api. And if you're doing it the normal old fashioned way, pip install youtube_transcript_api. Or if you're using conda install -c conda-forge youtube-transcript-api. So when you do it on conda, you've just got hyphens instead of underscores. This is the conda page. It was last updated 3 months ago, so it's very recent. It's quite a new project actually, only 248 downloads. Anyway, when you've installed it, or when you want to install it using conda, you'll get a screen like this and it'll prompt you that you need to update or install the following packages, CA certificates, Certifi and conda, and just say yes to agree to these. They're quite small. Right, this is a screenshot of this is a screenshot of the documentation. Couldn't get my words out then. Not getting senile, honestly, it's just lack of coffee. Right, from youtube_transcript-api, import youtube-transcript-api. So just copy and paste that from the documentation. Then this is the good bit, youtube-transcript-api.get_transcript, and then in brackets, video ID. So there's no quotes or anything for that, so just paste it straight into the brackets. And if you were to copy what they've shown here, you would actually just get a large Python dictionary inside, or multiple Python dictionaries inside a list. So in a minute I'll show you some code and I'll show you how to actually extract that. If you want different languages, you can specify different languages. So what it does is it actually checks in sequence. So it'll check, if you put DE, then it'll check for German transcript first and then English and so on and so on. So you can put many, many different flavors there, and it'll try and get the one that you want in sequence in order of priority. Right, so this is some code. This is what we will get when we run it. So this is just a little taster. And if you like this code, or if you like the project rather, then donate if possible to Jonas Depoix at web.de. Go to the documentation and you will see his donate button there. And if you like what I do, then Don't forget to check out Red and Green, which is my website, and there's links to various different things. We got a bit of network automation, my GitHub page, my blog, where I just put a few technical notes, more than a few even. Data extraction challenges using jQuery and working with JSON and APIs. And there we go. So if you'd like to see some actual code, okay, so we've done the Conda install, we've installed youtube-transcript-api. If you want to do it with pip, then you don't need to do the Conda bit. So this is where we do the import, the module from youtube-transcript-api, import youtube-transcript-api. Then just a quick note here, you can have a list of just a couple of settings. So as I mentioned just now, this is a note about the language settings. And also, with regard to the video ID, if the video ID starts with a hyphen, you'll have to mask the hyphen using the backslash. So yeah, if it's got a hyphen at the start, you just need to put a backslash. Otherwise, the code will think that it's an argument. Or it'll think it's an argument name. So the main code, if you're ready to see that, well, I've already gone and extracted a video ID. So all I've done is just found a video. I found one that had subtitles. And if it doesn't have subtitles, you'll get a notification saying that it's not possible to get subtitles for this video. So the main code, out ls. So that's going to be the list which captures the output of all of the subtitles. So tx equals YouTube transcript API dot get underscore transcript. And there we can see the parameters that you pass to it. So you can pass to it the video ID, the languages, and it can also cope with proxies and cookies. The default is no proxy and no cookies. So the default is also English if you don't specify languages either. So I could actually leave that out. Well, I'm just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to leave DE in here. And you'll see what happens, because when DE is not available, it will then just go off and get English. Be aware that these are two-letter country codes. What was I using the other day? Something was using three-letter country codes. I think that may have been, I don't know, was it Ginger? Something like that. No, not Ginger itself, but something I was doing with Ginger. For I in TX, So the object to which YouTube transcript API.get, so I've just called TX. So for each item in that object, so it's basically returning a list. For each item in that list, we want to do this. So this is the bit that you wouldn't see on the documentation, and this is the bit that actually picks out the text. If you don't do this, you'll end up with a JSON dictionary, and you'll end up with start times, end times, and so on. It won't provide you with what you need if you're planning on working with just the actual text. For instance, if you're about to do something with NLP, maybe not sentiment analysis, well, maybe sentiment analysis, maybe creating a bag of words, analyzing part of speech, etc., etc. So what we've got here is text. So we're just outputting one line of text, and then we're going to append it to our list. And also what I'm going to do is open a new file for append. And then I'm going to write the text from the current line as we go through the video. So obviously the video runs that way because of the timings. So as we go through time, we keep getting a new line, 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 so on. And that's why I've put new line here. Without the new line, you just end up with a massive long, you know, just imagine 40-minute video just with one line of text. Not good. Right, then all I've done in there, just for a little bit of a bonus, I've added in from sklearn feature extraction, just added in count vectorizer, and it converts a collection of text documents to a matrix of token counts. And from here you could go off and do your own thing with NLP and so on. You could even reject a video if it didn't have a certain phrase. So you could go off and get subtitles from many, many videos. And rather than watching 20 videos on climate change, you could get the 20 transcripts, and then you could just search each of those transcripts for certain words, such as polar bear. Maybe only three of those videos have got the word polar bear. So rather than watching 20 videos, you then know that you've only got to watch those three videos. So this isn't all about hacking or web scraping or doing anything naughty. It can be used purely to save your time. And I know YouTube would probably like you to watch 20 videos that all last an hour long, but I think they would still be happy if you're only watching three videos that are an hour long each. You know, 3 hours is better than nothing. And you probably wouldn't sit down and watch 20 hours worth of videos anyway, so then what would you do? I don't know. You'd probably just go off and read a book. So with that, all that being said, I think it's time to actually demonstrate the code. So what I'm just going to do is I'll just comment out this bit for starters. And what we'll do is we will just run the main code, which should just generate us a text file. So if I just bring up the sidebar, and you see I've already run it once, so let's just delete that text file. And let's run it. So it's run, and that was when I run my code within VS Code, it sends all this output to the screen. And it ran successfully, no error message. And I know it ran successfully because I've got that OP text file back. And let's have a look. So, hi everyone. Welcome to this lecture series on OSI file storage service. And in this particular module, we're going to introduce the file storage service and look at it, some of its characteristics. My name is Rohit Ryan. I'm part of the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure team. So that's pretty good. I mean, there's very few kind of errors there. Last week I was adding subtitles to my videos about ginger, and that's obviously J-I-N-J-A. And yeah, the subtitles were just calling it ginger, as in G-I-N-G-E-R, and I had to change that everywhere. Ginger obviously being a plant or a flavor of biscuits. Right, so that is the output file, which, okay, so far so good. Before we run, let's just delete that, and I'll run that on let's test it on a different, come on, delete. I've made the font really big, and it's, I made it a bit harder to do what I normally do. So, right, okay. So let's just get another YouTube video. YouTube. And anyone got any requests? Tell you what, let's do one of my videos. So there's two ways of doing it. So an easy way to actually get it is just to click share and then just go in here, and that's the video ID there. So I said it was easy. There you go. Right click copy, and let's replace what I had in here before with my new video ID. So there we go. And this should work because I have done the subtitles for it. So if we run it, may take a while. Wow, that was only about, 2 seconds? And because that's interesting. I've actually enabled German subtitles on my most recent videos. And it's actually gone off and got the German. And I think there's some characters missing from there is. I think it's probably missing the umlauts. So you've got the German translation there because it tries German first. If I take out German from there, it will just obviously just get the English. So I'm going to delete that. Run it one more time. Just to prove that it does multi-language. And well, it's even got... I don't know why it's putting this in here. Oh, it's not liking the new line characters, is it? Maybe. Don't know. That's, in fact, let's just open that with, let's just open that with a different text editor, shall we? I'm just going to open that with, let's just open it with WordPad. This is, I'm back on the Windows machine because I've been having some issues with flickering on the screen using my Linux Mint and OBS. So here we go. Yeah, hello everybody. Today we're looking at how to scrape videos content from YouTube. So what I mean is we're going to download the video. So yeah, technically you could call it scraping if you want, or scrapping if you... Yeah, don't get me started on scrapping. So this is just how it's rendered in VS Code, so don't worry about that. It opens fine in a text editor, a normal text editor. So there we go. And right, who wants to just run a little bit of natural language process? Well, it's not. We're not really doing anything clever. All we're just doing is we're running Count Vectorizer, which will creates vectorizer object, and then it prints you the identified unique words along with their indices. So let's just run that and that'll print to the screen. So there we go, that's all the unique words with their indices. So if we wanted, we could check this text for a certain word. We could check it for scraping. Scraping. So there we go. I hope this has been interesting. The whole reason I made this video was because I had a subscriber ask if, following on from the previous videos where I've extracted text from the images created from stills taken from the video, the subscriber said, could I extract the transcripts programmatically? And obviously this is it, this is the solution. So YouTube transcript API. And the benefit or the beauty of it is you don't even need to register for an API key and an auth token and so on. This is usable on any video. So yeah. Obviously YouTube haven't blocked it or anything. So I know there's the bit about proxies and so on, but for all intents and purposes, that's not needed here, not in this example, or not from the UK. So perhaps if you're trying to access this from China or somewhere, maybe you need to use a proxy, I don't know. But there we go. So hopefully you've enjoyed this and found it useful. Don't forget to, as usual, subscribe, thumbs up, because of the algos. Thank you.